Throughout history, there have been many instances of monarchs murdering members of their own families. This was often done as a way to eliminate potential rivals to the throne or to consolidate power. Cleopatra engineered the murder of two siblings, one of whom was also her husband. And Atahualpa, the last Inca emperor, ordered the execution of his half-brother from a Spanish prison. One well-known example is the Roman Emperor Caligula, who had many members of his own family killed during his reign from 37 to 41 CE. Another example is the English King Henry VIII, who had two of his own wives, Anne Boleyn and Catherine Howard, executed on charges of treason. He also had several of his closest advisors and allies executed, including his own chancellor, Thomas More. But even those royals might have been aghast at the actions of Russian Tsar Peter the Great, who in 1718 had his eldest son tortured to death for allegedly conspiring against him. Peter the Great was born on June 9, 1672, in Moscow, Russia. His parents were Tsar Alexis I of Russia and his second wife Natalia Naryshkina. Peter was the 14th child of his father and the first child of his mother, who was Alexis' second wife. Peter's mother played an important role in his life and education, as she encouraged his interest in the sciences and foreign languages. However, Peter's childhood was marked by family conflict and political turmoil, including the struggle for the throne after his father's death in 1676. After a period of political instability, Peter and his half-brother Ivan V were declared joint rulers of Russia in 1682, but real power was wielded by their sister Sophia until Peter gained control. When Peter took the throne, Russia was a relatively isolated and backward country, and Peter was determined to modernize it. He opened up Russia to the west, building a new capital, St. Petersburg, on the Baltic Sea, and sending Russians to study in Europe. Over time, Peter consolidated his power and centralized the government under his control. He also expanded Russia's territory, conquering new lands in the Baltic region, Ukraine, and Central Asia. Peter the Great became the first Russian emperor in 1721, when he officially changed his title from Tsar to Emperor of all Russia. This change was part of Peter's efforts to modernize Russia and align it more closely with the European powers. The decision to adopt the title of emperor was not just a symbolic one. It also reflected Peter's desire to create a more centralized and bureaucratic government, based on the models of the Western European monarchies. The new title gave him greater legitimacy as a ruler, both within Russia and in his dealings with other European powers. Peter's decision to become an emperor was announced at a ceremony in Moscow's Dormition Cathedral on October 22, 1721. At the same time, he also introduced a new coat of arms and a new national anthem, reflecting the changes to Russia's status as an empire. The adoption of the title of emperor was not without controversy, however. Some members of the Russian nobility saw it as a betrayal of traditional Russian values and customs, and there were fears that it would lead to a loss of Russian identity and independence. Peter the Great is remembered for his many reforms and innovations that modernized Russia and transformed it into a major European power. Peter modernized and professionalized the Russian military, creating a standing army and navy based on Western models. He introduced new tactics, weaponry, and uniforms, and he built a network of military schools to train officers. Peter the Great reorganized the Russian government, creating a system of administrative provinces and districts, and appointing officials based on merit rather than birth. He also established a Senate to oversee the government and a College of Foreign Affairs to handle diplomatic relations. He opened Russia's first state-funded school for boys, the School of Mathematical and Navigation Sciences, which trained students in science, mathematics, and foreign languages. He also established the Academy of Sciences in St. Petersburg, which became a center for scientific research and scholarship. Peter encouraged the adoption of Western culture and customs in Russia, including fashion, cuisine, and etiquette. He introduced the Julian calendar, which was used in Western Europe, and he promoted the use of the Russian language in literature and the arts. Peter the Great encouraged trade and industry in Russia, building new ports, canals, and roads to facilitate commerce. He also established state monopolies on certain goods, such as salt and tobacco, to generate revenue for the government. Overall, Peter's reforms and innovations helped modernize Russia and transform it from a medieval state into a major European power. Much to Peter's chagrin, however, his eldest son and heir apparent, the Tsarevich Alexei, grew up thinking differently. Alexei's mother, Eudoxia, was both pious and conservative, and her marriage to Peter proved rocky. In 1698, when Alexei was 8 years old, Peter left her and forced her into a convent. From then on, Alexei was raised largely by his aunts, though he also received Enlightenment-era tutoring in foreign languages and mathematics, and studied abroad in present-day Germany. Like many children of European monarchs, Alexei didn't often see his father, who spent much of his reign away fighting the Ottomans and Swedes and traveling around Western Europe. Instead, Alexei was surrounded by a Moscow entourage that believed in less Westernization and a bigger role for the Orthodox Church and the aristocracy. That began to change around 1711, when Peter married the Tsarevich off to a German princess named Charlotte. Though relatively pleased with her husband at first, Charlotte soon found herself lonely and isolated, complaining in letters of Alexei's emotional unavailability and excessive drinking. According to some sources, Alexei was a heavy drinker who often became belligerent and disorderly when under the influence of alcohol. Charlotte died of postpartum complications following the birth of their second child in 1715, by which time Alexei had begun an extramarital affair with a serf, Afrosina Fedorova. When Peter the Great learned of Alexei's relationship with Afrosina and their children, he was furious and demanded that Alexei end the affair. Alexei refused, and their relationship continued despite his father's disapproval. Meanwhile, still sore over his mother's banishment, Alexei did not attend the 1712 wedding of Peter and his second wife, Catherine. Bookish, timid, and far less physically imposing than Peter, the Tsarevich constantly complained of ill health and is said to have once purposely injured his hand rather than submit to one of his father's demands. The father-son relationship cracked for good in October 1715 when Peter penned Alexei a letter bemoaning his lack of military prowess and threatening to deprive him. Peter added that he would rather pass the crown to a worthy stranger than to my own unworthy son. The terrified Tsarevich volunteered to relinquish his claim to the throne, saying that he felt unfit for service and that the Tsar should be a more vigorous man than I am. Despite Alexei's assurances that he wanted nothing to do with government, Peter worried that his opponents would rally around his son. Peter therefore ordered Alexei to either strive for the succession or become a monk. Alexei agreed to enter a monastery, but rather than actually do so, he borrowed money and fled the country in disguise in 1716, accompanied only by Afrosina and three servants. Alexei fled Russia and sought refuge in Austria, where he renounced his claim to the Russian throne in exchange for protection from his father. Prior to his escape, a confidant purportedly warned Alexei, "Remember, if your father sends somebody to persuade you to return, do not do it. He will have you publicly beheaded." But the Tsarevich ignored this sage advice. Peter eventually convinced Alexei to return to Russia, promising him a pardon and a role in the government. Reluctantly crossing back into Russia in early 1718, Alexei fell to his knees in front of Peter and begged for forgiveness as part of a public spectacle in which he was disinherited. Peter then demanded that Alexei name his accomplices, which led to the torture of dozens of the Tsarevich associates. A few were executed, while others were banished or imprisoned. Peter even took action against his ex-wife, Eudoxia, confining her to a second, more remote convent. At this point, Alexei apparently still hoped for a quiet life with Afrosina in the countryside. But even she ended up testifying against him, after which Alexei was jailed in early 1718. During his interrogations, Alexei Petrovich, the son of Peter the Great, made several statements critical of his father and the government he had established. He also expressed his desire to abdicate from the throne and live a peaceful life away from the court. Alexei accused his father of being a tyrant who destroyed the traditional way of life in Russia. He expressed his opposition to the reforms and policies of Peter the Great, particularly his efforts to westernize Russia. It is worth noting that the exact nature of Alexei's statements is disputed among historians, as there are different versions of the interrogations and the transcripts are not entirely reliable. Peter the Great was furious with his son and ordered a trial. Alexei was found guilty of plotting against his father and was sentenced to death. Most sources state that he was whipped 25 times on June 19, 1718, and that when the torture started up again 5 days later, he confessed to conspiring for the death of his father. On June 26, 1718, Alexei died in prison from being tortured and beaten. The official cause of death was recorded as heart failure. The circumstances surrounding Alexei's death have been the subject of much debate among historians, with some arguing that he may have been poisoned or strangled by his captors. However, there is no conclusive evidence to support these theories. At any rate, even by the bloody standards of royal family feuds, Peter's cruelty stands out as unique. So far as we know, there were no other European monarchs who oversaw the torture of their own children. After Alexei's arrest and execution, Afrosina and their children were imprisoned in Russia. Eventually, they were released and allowed to leave the country, and they settled in Livonia, present-day Estonia.